I'm going to attempt to be calm and collective this video because I want to get concise to the point and just not waste anybody else's day, because I was really contemplating on making this video. But the overall thing about this video is that Studio Pierrot members are getting harassed more pertainingly to the Bleach animation staff. So how did we get to this point? Well, apparently on a few days ago, I was tagged massively on Twitter to talk about this specific topic, and I waited a few days because I wanted to kind of understand everything to its fullest without really kind of jumping the gun emotionally like I usually do with many things. But it would seem that a few animators from the Bleach animation staff have actually come out and talked about the negativity and the harassment that they get quite frequently from members of the Twitter public, talking about how they're bad and how they should retire or get off the series, or how you know, it's a still frame slideshow, etc., etc. Now, of course, the people who we have as a community have seen actually post these kind of hateful comments have originated from somewhere, and I will, you know, talk about that briefly later on in the video. But I mostly want to pertain to the idea of people harassing staff and what this can conclude to. And I think people wanted me to talk about it the most is because, you know, you have people from the Bleach staff actually consider outright leaving the project altogether, the Bleach animation project, which again, you know, considering MAPPA has all these connections and Pierrot kind of doesn't to that degree in comparison, you know, and I'm talking very much like off the dome here, so please don't try and correct me. But what I'm trying to essentially say is that, you know, we're good with what we got at the moment. We don't really want to push anyone away, anyways it's just going to cause more issues later on. But the point is of all of this is that yes, that is a problem in and of itself, and truth be told, if I made a video, could I change anything? The answer is simply no. I can't control people. I can't tell people to stop, because they will do what they do, and I truly don't believe they are people that are part of my community, or this video will blow up big enough to the point where, you know, everybody will see it. So why have I made this video? To kind of talk about a video that I was originally going to do after Core 2, and that was the mindset of comparisons. And I've noticed that since MAPPA really came into the scene, especially with Attack on Titan, Chainsaw Man, Jujutsu Kaisen, and stuff like that, you know, Core 1 had its backlash with, you know, the fact that, yes, this series after 10 years coming back couldn't, I guess, compared to Chainsaw Man, which, you know, the new keyword of that season was character acting. You know, Chainsaw Man had all this love, had all this fluidity, had this, you know, over the top, over, you know, I guess, animation, which wasn't really needed, nor did it really benefit the story in any way. It was just a flex for the sake of giving a flex. And, you know, when you have a series that has, you know, been hyped to come back after 10 years, people that are Chainsaw Man fans, you know, regardless of whether people think Bleach is good or not, there is, you know, psychologically speaking, there is somewhat of a threat. Everybody wants their series to be the biggest series of the season. They want their series to be the most talked about series of that season. That's why I don't know what goes on in my anime list, but Fullmetal Alchemist Bros do not want anything toppling its number one top spot, because it's the thing that they kind of hold on to, I guess, or maybe the moderators do. I'm not quite sure what the reason really is, but again, stuff like that, it's toxic. And then we won't even get onto the review bombing of things as well. But the amount of things that I have seen where it comes down to pure insecurity, that, you know, you have to beat your opponent to the ground so bad that you have to make 600 alt accounts just to downvote a series on some kind of scoring website just so your series stands up on top for those 12 weeks, is insecurity at its finest. Regardless if your show is better animated than another show, the fact remains is that the attacking means that you are not kind of confident within your own series to do what it needs to do on its own. And the reason why I bring this up now is because the moment that Jujutsu Kaisen and Bleach were, you know, stated to come out together, you know, Jujutsu Kaisen fans, they want to big up their series. They want to say, oh, you know, 3 episodes in and it's already more high detailed and more high animated, Sakuga, more than Bleach ever is. And like the contexts are different. Both studios have their pluses or pros and cons. That, you know, in MAPPA's case, they have a massive network of people and more of an incentivization to work for MAPPA than Pierrot at the moment. And I always say to people, you know, for people that are disappointed in Bleach's animation, or they are, you know, or feel lackluster about it, I always say to people, with all due respect, is this the best looking show that Puro has ever done? And quite simply, the answer is yes. You know, I'm not talking about, you know, an advert here or there, or I'm not talking about a special, you know, like that you know, Naruto PV that went on for like a few minutes. No, I'm talking about like an actual animated series, you know, that's going on quite long. Is this the best thing that Puro has done? Consistently, I would argue absolutely yes. I would say that this is currently potentially Puro's peak, potentially. And I think that that is for Puro, who I personally believe fell off for a long time. They've kind of recovered a little bit of their reputation in this regard. They used to be a powerhouse studio, but like when people heard Puro after like Tokyo Ghoul's massacre, people weren't really confident within Puro. But I digress. The constant, you know, insecurity of comparison with Chainsaw Man, Jujutsu Kaisen, and even One Piece is getting out of hand. The community has become so obsessed with the idea that their show needs to be talked about that week. Like, their show, they need a valid reason why they stand what they stand or why they support what they support. And if that means, like, absolutely trashing on the other opposition, then so be it. And it was like that in the Big Three. Except the Big Three era of chapter reviewing was quite a competitive kind of back and forth. It was never slandering or never harassing to that degree. It was always just competitive. But in this regard, in the age of Twitter, where you can just have an anime profile picture, make a bunch of alt accounts, and just spam whatever you want to spam with no consequence, I guess you will do the damage without reaping the consequence for the action. So, and it needs to stop. I mean, I remember Gear 5, right? When Gear 5 was coming out, everybody was hyping up this specific episode, right? Even though it was the episode after that should have been hyped, but the episode where Gear 5 was supposed to happen, for weeks and for months, there was campaigns. There was One Piece fans attacking the Dragon Ball fans. They were attacking the Naruto fans. They were attacking the Bleach fans. They were attacking every fan. JJK fans, they were so on their high horse. And then, of course, the One Piece live action coming out shortly after as well. They were on their highest high, and they really wanted everybody to know that they existed. And it's a bit weird because it was like that little kid that's in the supermarket that just wants to shout, "I'm here, everybody see me." And it's like, we know, shut the fuck up, like, you annoying fucking piece of shit. Like, just backhand the kid, no candy for you. But it's so weird that, like, fandoms have to be so extra just to make their point. We know you exist. We can see the animation. It looks all right. The way you're gassing it up doesn't really yield the result. Was Gear 5 okay? Yeah, it was all right. It had a lot of criticisms, but for the gassing and the hype that you pushed it to be, it should have been the episode after, which was the main focus. But because it was this one episode that was going to break the internet, and everybody wants a Dragon Ball Super break in the internet. Everybody wants that for some reason. I get it. You want your series to do something monumental. But I digress. I'm going on a tangent, and I apologize. The point is, where did this come from? Again, as the screenshots that I will show you on screen at the moment, it came from an insecure little man from a Telegram group from OCUFS Telegram group, a leaker. He is a person that is quite active on Twitter that I have had personal issues with. But that aside, you know, I won't put everyone within the same cloth, though I do have my issues and I have brought up with these issues with personally. That at the end of the day, this person from that group went out of their way to harass the animators and still is. There was somebody in my Discord group that went out of their way to tell animators to stop working. I told them to stop. They didn't. They got banned and kicked from my community. The person's name was Trafalgar Law, or Trafalgar F Law. So if he's in your Discord server, well, maybe you know him. But I wasn't having any of it. I don't accept that. Have your criticisms, but don't attack animators. You know, they're just doing the job that they're told to do. Do not be that person. It is not constructive at all, and it's not helping anybody within any situation. You have a loving fan base, and you show that support and that love, and the animators, if they have time, may go back and make some corrections within the Blu-rays. Maybe some of the animators aren't happy with it themselves, but it is what it is. We can't control them, and they can't control the production, and you know, the production can't control the production committee, you know, so on and so forth. And then of course censored scenes like TV regulations and whatnot. There's a lot that people don't know about the anime side, and that's why I tend to hold off on my criticisms until after the course, so I can get a bigger, wider scope of things to relay. But at the end of the day, when we talk about toxic communities, and you know, we look at the Ichirukis, how they sent death threats to Kubo because they didn't get their thing, are they a part of the Bleach fandom? Absolutely. Can we segment them into a group? Absolutely, because a lot of them on Twitter do and did do that, especially Tumblr days. Oh, okay, let's segment them down to Tumblr days, because that was a wildness. But like, in this specific situation, the people I blame is not only the Twitter group chats and the Sakuga enthusiasts, but I do blame groups a little bit, like OCUF's group. And because I've been in there for quite a long time, I've seen the constant hating that I will show on screen right now, just a smidgen of what I've seen. You know, not only the 400 screenshots that just completely, you know, manipulate what the episode actually is and was, and the tweets of Doom posting that I think we've all seen publicly. You encourage that type of behavior where you have a community that wants to shit on Bleach all the time, and you play into that card. And you know, I've spoken to OCUF, and they seem to be willing to change things and make things better, and I'll give them the benefit of the doubt, right? I will. I believe everybody can change. But at the end of the day, when 80% of your group is just shitting on Bleach and having a hearty, hearty old time with taking the piss out of Sakai, and not so much Kano, but like Taguchi and Hiramitsu, Uhimatsu, you know, that's when you're like, well, you're one step closer from animators getting harassed. And then we got to that point. So yeah, while no specific group in particular is sending a charge of army over to attack somebody, you're increasing and endorsing a behavioral trait that keeps pushing, what can we do more to fuel this flame? What can we do to piss off Bleach fans? What can we do to make Bleach fall so one can potentially rise? And that's the mentality. There was no specific point in this video. I just want to say, and I don't know if I'll promote the hashtag purely because that DBZ Imran kind of endorsed, because some of the animators did say that they didn't want a lot of interactions or a lot of mentions, because that in and of itself does bother them. So I'll respect that. It's a bit inflicting of what I feel I should and shouldn't do, but I think the message is clear. I don't care how much you hate a series. I don't care how much you want your series to be the number one of that year. After that year, you move on to another show, and then you stand that show. Your mind is simply so smooth-brained that you're not committed or loyal until it ends, and then you move on to the next thing. And at the grand scheme of it, it doesn't affect you. It doesn't really affect anybody else. You are just a puppet in the big marketing scheme, and that's fine. You know, the review bombing, making 600 accounts to review bomb something, like, what could you have been doing with that time? You could be getting a job and paying rent. That's what you should be doing. But I digress. I do feel it is unfortunate, and I apologize on behalf of the Bleach community. I don't actually think a lot of the harassment comes from the Bleach community. We have a lot of impersonators, such as One Piece fans or MAPPA fans, that just change their profile picture and cause issues. The Bleach community has its own issues and groups of issues within its community. But I don't think harassing animators is part of any group within the Bleach community specifically. So I think everyone's kind of unanimous with that fact. But other than that, I'm just waffling. I didn't really know how to construct this video, and I don't really know what to say. So I'm just opening my mouth and hoping that words come out and that you enjoy it. But that's the situation. Show love to the Bleach animators. Of course, when it is appropriate to do so. If they post a picture, if they talk about the episode, go show them love. Don't spam them, though. I think they're very confused about what's going on right now, especially with the hashtag. And we should just leave them alone and just show them love when they, you know, talk about Bleach. And that's really all you can ask for. But in terms of these bad actors, we can't really do anything. They exist, they have pathetic little lives, and, you know, like, that's the problem, is that you can't really critique them either because they're hiding behind a profile picture. There's no consequence. They can just make another Twitter account. But when I fuck up, I have to accept it, because I'm a name and I'm a face and people know who I am, and I can't just make another account. But hey, I can get cancelled for things that people do on a daily basis. So, you know, if I talk shit about Boruto, you know, like, I have an opinion about it. I'm not attacking any animators at all. But if I talk shit, again, it's as an example, if I talk shit about Naruto or Boruto, right, I can't just delete the account and move on to another one and then do the exact same thing again, because that's just not how it works. So there's no consequence for them, but there is for I guess big people. And that's the sad reality of it. It is what it is. And yeah, don't be insecure, Bleach fandom. Don't be insecure. Don't worry about, you know, statistics or scorings or whether your episode has the Sakuga. As long as you enjoy it, that's all that matters. We waited 10 years for it, and I think it's doing, you know, there's things that can be done better, but overall, it's a great job. It really is a great adaptation. And I can't wait to talk about what I finally think of the full shebang after Court 2 ends. So, with that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine David Hansen, and as always, people, peace out.